So in today's topic, we are going to discuss about how to calculate power and energy for a RO pump. RO pump means reverse osmosis pump. Okay. This is a reverse osmosis pump which we commonly use for RO plant for the home purpose, not for the public, not a big one, it's a small one. It looks like this. Okay, so the company is FSLO reverse osmosis booster pump, model number. This is called plate details. So whenever you buy something, you should go through the plate details. Okay, the pump is designed for use with reverse osmosis water purification system. Check carefully about the specifications before applying to the other application. Suppose somebody wants to apply for some other application, then they have to go and study these details. Okay, so what are the important details we have from this? Nominal flow rate, it has given us 1.6 capital LPM. Pump pressure 130 psi, maximum inlet pressure 60 psi, operating voltage 24 bar 36 volts DC. It is not AC, it is DC, 26 volts or 36 volts. Working amperes is 0.9. There is a difference between starting ampere and working ampere. Starting current usually will be very high, working current usually will be less. Suppose somebody is sitting, say your mother is sitting in the bicycle back seat, and the first pedal you have to give enormous force, right, to pedal. Likewise, the starting of any vehicle or something, the starting current is high. I already told you about in locomotive, the starting current is 1100 amperes for good strain, and the running current is 600 or 700 amperes, very high current. Okay, so the working amperes they have given us 0.9 amperes. So this is, and we have two wires here, positive and negative. Okay, and there are, see, here you can see that inlet wall, outlet wall, all those things. This is a stand that has to be fixed. Okay, now having given all these details, now we have to calculate the power, energy, what are the requirements. First of all, in our supply in India, we have 230 volts, 50 hertz AC supply. So that has to be converted into DC. DC, that too 24 bar 36 volts. Okay, it is not 5 volts or 12 volts like that. So you should supply for that 24 or 36 volts. That part number is given there. There you have to check. So we will assume 36 volts DC is required for that water pump. And this I am working current, and the starting current I assume to be 1 amps, okay. I am assuming the starting current is 1 amps, but usually after starting, it is for only for starting the motor 1 amps. Afterwards, when it starts working, running, it becomes 0.9 amperes. Okay. So here RO means reverse osmosis booster pump, that we are going to do the power calculation. So we all know that 1 kilowatt hour is 1 unit. So power is equal to V into I. So I assume 36 volts into current. Of course, I am making use of starting current 1, so it is 36 watt. Then energy is equal to power into time. Okay. Energy is equal to power 36 watt into, assume I am running the motor, I am switching on and running the motor. RO plant is switched on for 1 hour. Okay, then it is switched off. So in that case, 1 hour, 36 watt hour. So we already know 1000 watt hour is equal to 1 unit. Therefore, 36 watt hour is equal to 0.036 unit. And if you assume 1 unit in India, that too in Tamil Nadu, if it is approximately say 5 rupees, it may be less only. I am assuming it to be 5 rupees. Okay, so if for this case 0.036 unit, it will be 0.18 rupees or 18 paise. So I am calling this as 25. That means if you run that motor for 1 hour with this much power rating, you have to pay the EB department 20 paise. So if you may see, okay, only just 20 paise. Okay, suppose if you work for morning 1 hour, you put the RO plan morning 1 hour, evening 1 hour. So in that case, 40 paise. And then it becomes, say, assume you are by operating this RO motor, you are spending 50 paise per day. Okay. So 1 month, assume 30 days, it will be roughly 15 rupees we are spending for water. But when you buy the can water, they are charging 20 rupees, 15 rupees, 25 rupees, like that. But we don't know how far it is. Can water is good, because somebody says they are mixing some chemicals like that. It may lead to cancer also because of those chemicals. So this is as far as purification of water is concerned. For home purpose, RO, you can use RO method of getting purified water, and that will be good for health also. So the idea of this topic is, you must know how to calculate, how to read the plate details, how to measure the current. See, these are all the data given there. But when you want to actually find out, you should connect. Say there, you must connect the 36 volts DC. Then you must connect a ammeter and that motor rod. This, assume this is motor plus minus, and you should see the current. That will be the correct value. But based on the plate details, I have calculated these values. Okay. Now another thing is, what is the resistance of the unit? That can be easily found. R is equal to V by I by Ohm's law. So V, we know, say 36 divided by 1 amps. That is 36 volts divided by 1 amps, which is equal to 36 volts. So roughly that value is around 50 ohms or 36 ohms of the entire unit. That's how you should calculate the resistance. So this is the basic idea of calculating power, energy, money we are spending for it, all these things. Hope you have understood this topic. Thanks for watching. Nandri.